Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's look at viewing invisibles in Pages and Word. So every once in a while I got a message from somebody asking me what are these blue dots that are between every word in some document they're working on, say in Pages. And what those blue dots are, if you see them, are they are invisibles, in particular spaces. And the reason you're seeing them is because under View, maybe by accident, you turned on Invisibles. So you have View, Hide Invisibles, or Show Invisibles. And you can see it turns them on or off. In addition to the spaces being represented as these dots, you'll see other characters as well, like a return or end of paragraph character right there. If you use Tabs, for instance, you'll see these little arrows for each tab. These are what are called invisibles, and it can be useful to actually view them. So what makes them useful is if you're writing a serious document and you want to make sure you have total control over what exactly is in the document, it allows you to see things. Like, for instance, what's the difference between a single space and a double space? Well, you can't normally see it. I mean, you get this bigger space here if you don't have invisibles, but it may not stand out right away, not on every line. And you just may not spot that. But if you show invisibles, you can see these two dots here a lot easier. It's even more apparent, for instance, if the alignment was just left aligned, you can see it's very hard to tell that there are two spaces here, but easier when you have invisibles. Likewise, what's the difference between, say, a tab and several spaces? If you hide invisibles, these may look the same quickly to your eye, but if you show it, quickly stands out that maybe somebody else who was working on the document, instead of hitting tab, they used a bunch of spaces, and you can replace that with a tab and see exactly what you've got there. The main ones you see will be the space, the tab, and the paragraph mark, but there are other ones. For instance, if you've ever used a non-breaking space, say there are two words that you do not want to break up across lines, even though there should be a visual space between them, you can actually select the space here and use Option Space. And Option Space, you can see it's a different character. There's a dot with a small marking above it, and that is a non-breaking space, meaning don't break this set of two words up over a line, but make it look like a regular space. If I were to hide invisibles, I can't tell the difference, and it's much easier to tell what's going on if I turn on invisibles. And there are lots of other really good uses. For instance, if you're including a lot of spaces between paragraphs, for instance, and you really want to know how many there are, it can be difficult to count them. But now, when you turn it on, it's very easy to see how many blank lines there are between something. Same thing with how many tabs are inserted before something. It's easy to see that with invisibles turned on. Now, you've got the ability to control the color of the invisibles right here in Preferences for Pages under General, and then there's a color control there for it. So if you don't like that blue, or perhaps you're using that same color for some text and you want the invisibles to stand out, you can easily change them in Pages. So you can find this kind of functionality on almost all word processing apps. The more advanced ones, that is. You don't find it in TextEdit, but you can find it in Microsoft Word, for instance. In Word, you would go to Word Preferences, and under View, you've got Show Non-Printing Characters, and you actually have some more options here. I'm just going to turn on all, and you can see now I can see the dots and the paragraph marks and the tabs and everything here. So you've got similar functionality. It's even a similar character here for that non-breaking space. And a lot of desktop publishing layout type programs also have Show Invisibles, because of course it's very important there to get the formatting and things between words exactly right on those. So look for those. They could help you if you do precision layout or precision documents, or if you've just accidentally turned it on, now you know what it is and how to turn it off.